personally.
I owe you one, Ta.
You having a go? I'm gonna put you in.
There you go. There you are. Some work for you.
This one won't be needing
That's
breakfast
right.
tomorrow.
Right. Mind you, I heard they're paying good money at the College of Medicine.
Someone's kicked the bucket.
We'll get to the bottom of
it. At least you're out of the stink, ain't you?
Help! There's a dead body here.
I wonder if I know the poor beggar.
Tragedy in the park.
Another chance to sort out a diabolical conundrum. One that I'll turn into a one-a-penny read for Purlock Publishing.
Slow down. Here now.
Go on about.
Now that I've seen this, I should ask more questions. I wonder if someone could tell me more about this.
I'll be making a move then.
This is about to get ugly. Really bloody ugly.
Sorry to hear about her murder. She was a patient here, but increasingly began to stop by socially. So she was meeting Dr. Alton in the park, was she? My understanding was that she was engaged to someone. In any case, the good doctor could do better, in my opinion. Perhaps now he will.
I don't know any of Dr. Alton's other patients. I don't know any of Dr. Alton's other...
Now that I've seen this, I should ask more questions. Now that I've seen this, I should ask more questions.
Oh my God, Prudence! How horrible! I was about to propose. But I don't understand. She and I didn't have a meeting arranged today. It is true that we sometimes meet in the park, but there was no arrangement for this morning. That's very odd indeed. Prudence was a patient here, but wasn't given this prescription. There's no reason that she should be carrying such a packet. You appreciate, I'm sure, that I cannot discuss the condition of any of my patients. An unfortunate incident. One of my patients became overexcited. That's very odd indeed.
Quite angry, actually. I was having such terrific results. I felt like a new man. Much more vigorous and outgoing. But the doctor has ended the prescription altogether for no reason.
Mr. Baxter apparently attacked the doctor yesterday. It was after hours, but the doctor did have a cut on his cheek. Poor man. Dr. Alton makes house calls to see him. Baxter doesn't come into the office. I make up the prescriptions and he picks them up at noon when I'm away at lunch.
Does she really have to do that?
That's something you don't see every day.
Huh.
Prudence and I are engaged to be married. I'm desperate to see her. She should be by any moment. She had something important to tell me. I'm worried she's going to break off the engagement. Prudence has been so distant lately. I believe she has a misplaced affection for her doctor, the cat. I would make a much more appropriate husband, and the wedding is planned.
I saw her kissing my man in the park, didn't I? I followed her to the street yesterday, but lost her. I'll come every day if need be, until I catch her again. That trollop better promise to let him alone, or I'll give her what for. He's all mine, I tell you. All the girls want a bit of Baxter, but they can't have him. You ask him yourself. He lives just that way.
I may have some problems, but brutally murdering people isn't one of them.
Oh God, it's true. I couldn't help myself. The power unleashed a creature within me. He seduced the innocent Prudence and then killed her to prevent us from marrying. It's too, too horrible.
I knew something was amiss with the medical powder, but didn't understand until you found those papers. Well done.
Off to the clink with you.